On the evening of Thursday, March 14, 2013, David Renz, who was subject to electronic monitoring while awaiting trial on charges of possessing child pornography, was able to tamper with his electronic monitoring equipment by removing it and then putting it back together. He violated his curfew by leaving his mother's house without his electronic monitoring equipment during the hours of 9 p.m. and 7 a.m., where he was ordered by the court to remain under supervision. It was on that evening, Thursday, March 14, 2013, that he was able to follow Lori Bresnahan and a 10-year-old girl from a gymnastics class at a mall in Clay, New York. Upon confronting them, he raped the young girl. He then forced the women into the car and drove to Verplank Road, where he proceeded to kill Lori Bresnahan and rape the 10-year-old girl. This was an extremely heinous crime, but for me, what was even more unbelievable was the fact that it could have been prevented, that David Renz tampered with his electronic monitoring device 46 times and was allowed to get away with it. So I wanna thank Senator DeFrancisco and Senator Valesky for co-sponsoring this bill with me that makes tampering a crime. I vote yes on this bill. Thank you, Mr. President.